Hello and welcome to all the viewers. In this video, we will discuss about the importance of sliding support for a pressure vessel. Also, we will discuss about the effect of boundary condition in thermal analysis using ANSYS workbench. All of us know that pressure vessel have different kinds of support. So like skirt support, lug support, leg support, as well as saddle supports. When we talk about saddle supports, it consists of two vertical supports, like one is fixed support and another is sliding support. So why there is a sliding support in case of pressure vessels? So in this video, we will discuss the same through the boundary condition in case of thermal analysis. So what we'll do now, we'll go to our presentation and we'll go to our ANSYS and there we'll discuss the present scenario. So this slide represents the learnings in this video. The very first we'll discuss about the problem statement of our present video and then we will move to our ANSYS learning part. So therefore very first we'll discuss about the thermal analysis and then we'll move towards our next part, that is boundary condition loading for sliding and fixed supports. Once we will apply this BC as well as loading, then we'll do the thermal coupled structural analysis and then we'll extract the results and we'll discuss and as well as we will interpret the results. And at the last, we'll perform the one more iteration, that is thermal displacement for sliding support. So we will calculate the analytical thermal displacement and then we will apply and then we will compare with the existing results. So this slide represents the problem statement of our present video. So here we need to perform thermal coupled structural analysis of heat exchanger for a following loading conditions. So the inside fluid temperature is 100 degrees centigrade. The ambient temperature is 22 degrees centigrade and the material is nothing but your stainless steel. So basically, if you see this schematic, it is nothing but shell and tube type heat exchangers. So when we talk about shell and tube type heat exchanger, there are two sides. One is shell side and another is tube side. I think we had already performed the thermal simulation for a shell and tube type heat exchangers. So you can go through that and then you will come to know how we can perform the simulation when there is a heat transfer. At present video, we have not considered the inside tubes. So basically, when there are tubes are present, so the tube side fluid will come through this and then it will move like that and then it will go through these tubes. This is basically the inlet and this is basically the outlet. This is basically the inlet. So it will come like this and then it will go and it will come out. Okay, so basically the tube side fluid will flow like this and when we talk about shell side fluid, it will come like this and then it will move over the tubes and then it will come through this. But at present video, we will not go into in that much depth. We will just consider the constant temperature, that is 100 degree, which is going to come inside the heat exchanger. And then we will apply the ambient temperature, that is basically the convection, 22 degree centigrade. And then we'll consider the material. So for present, we'll discuss our present scenario. So here, if you see, there are two supports. So these are called as a sliding support. The very first is your fixed support and another is your sliding support. Why it is called a sliding support? If you see here, it is basically mounted on a foundation and there are circular holes. But if you see here, there are slots are provided. So what does this slot means? So slot means it is allowed to move in this respective direction. And why it is so? It is because this heat exchanger or these things are applied at higher temperature and due to conduction as well as convection, you will find there is also a temperature effect on this. So what will happen? It will try to expand in longitudinal direction. So in order to account that effect, there are slots are provided. So basically it will reduce the thermal stresses when we put a such kind of slots. Suppose if you have same kind of holes over here, that is the fixed foundation, then in that case it is not allowed to expand. So what happens, there will be chances of higher stresses and the failure at the saddle connections. So in order to avoid that you will find always there is a one fixed support and another is a sliding support in order to account the thermal effect. The same we will go to study through the FEA. So what we will do now, we will go to ANSYS and there we will discuss the same. So now we are in our ANSYS workbench. So if you see here, the very first you need to just drag and drop your respective steady state thermal system from your analysis system. So you just need to drag and drop like this. I will drag over here and then you can couple the different like that, static, structural, and if you are doing further, you just drag like this. Okay, so like that you need to connect the different system with each other, different analysis system with each other. Okay, so I will going to use the same because it will reduce our time. Okay, the very first you just need to double click and then it will open your ANSYS design modeler. So if you see here, this is what your heat exchanger geometry. So I had already did few of the geometry cleanup operations. So what I did, basically I had removed the inside tubes and then I simplified these flanges and then I had extracted the mid surface for this bottom supports. Okay, the purpose of extracting mid surface that we will going to use the shell mesh and it will reduce the computation time. Okay, now as discussed earlier, this is called as a fixed support and this is called as a sliding support. The purpose behind it is that if you see the holes, you will find there is no this is nothing but your circular hole and here it is nothing but these slots. So what does it that, as we know that bolt will be circular and the slot provides the additional sliding movements. Okay, but here there is no provision for that, so that's why this is called as a sliding support. And the purpose is that the very first is that as we discussed, due to the thermal expansion it will going to expand and that's why it will affect to reduce the thermal stresses. The another is like we can easily mount this, the very first we can mount that and then this, then we can mount this and this, this can mount this heat exchanger. Okay, so that is also the same, but the major purpose is that to take care or to account the effect of thermal effect. Okay, so once your design modeler geometry cleanup or everything is done, then you can go to your ANSYS mechanical. The before that you can project this over that because there is only two contacts in this. Now I will show you, the very first part is nothing but the solid bodies and the second part is nothing but your shell body. Okay, so I will write in front of you shell body and then next you will find this is nothing but our solid body. Okay, now we can go to our mechanical. So we will refresh that. So now if you see here, our mechanical is open. Now if we refreshing the geometry, so still you can find, okay, it is done. Now you just double click and here there are different decks as we discussed earlier. The very first is that material detail. So I will show you, you just double click over here and there are two details like structural steel and this stainless steel. I just find out this from, you just need to double click on engineering data and then you can click on general materials and here you will find there are different general materials which are already provided in engineering data sources. So out of that you can just use the stainless steel, you just need to click and then you will find the book symbols. So it represents that it is included in our material details. Okay, so now you can use this stainless steel and you can suppress this structural steel. Okay, just close this and you right click over here and refresh. Okay, so now if you see here the material, you will find here stainless steel, you can assign from this and similarly over here shell and solid bodies. Now by default there are two contacts are created, So these are like auto contacts. We will going to use the same. We just cross check, and here we can put. Okay. So now similarly another contact over here. Okay, this is also fine. There are only two contacts because this solid body, we created all this body parts in a single part, bodies in a single part. Similarly, we'll see here shell, different bodies in a single part. So you can use this by connection option, and then you can see the connectivity. So if you see this triple edge, nothing but your green edge, which represent the connections between the different bodies. Now if you see, this edge is not connected with that, so we can do that. Similarly over here, then what we can do, we can go to design modeler and we can click over this four bodies here like that, and tool, surface extension, apply, and instead of fix, let's see the try with the next. So what we are doing, we are just extending so that it is having the connectivity. Okay, now if you see here, there is a connections. So in actual there should be a weld, but we are assuming that by using a connection. Okay, now let's check that in a ANSYS mechanical. Now if you see, these are connections are provided, connectivity, and we'll delete this additional contact. Once you will refresh each and every time, it will going to update the contact. So in order to avoid that, you just need to generate automatic contact on a refresh. You just keep that no. So whenever you will refresh, it will not going to create the auto contacts. Okay, now let's talk about the meshing. So this is just, I just use the generate 15 mm for this, like 40 mm, and I further use some face meshing for this bottom. We'll just use this extend to limit because we will going to fix on that, so that's why I am using that as a face meshing. So just generate the mesh for this setting. So in actually you should use the quite finer mesh across the thickness. You should use at least minimum 3 elements. Okay, so now our meshing is performed. Now once meshing is done, then we can very first we can perform the thermal simulations. So in order to do the thermal simulations, what we need to do that, so very first we need to apply a temperature. So if you see here, highlighted green faces showing that we had selected the inside fluidic surfaces. So you can do like, you just create a cross sections. I had created that, and you can check. Okay, so that is the very first load, that is 100 degree centigrade. So you can check your here, that is 100 degree centigrade temperature we had applied. And the next is the convection. So now if you see, this is nothing but our convection on a solid bodies. So what I will do, I will apply in front of you, so that how we can apply insert convections, and then you can select this face. You can use extend to limit. Similarly over here. Okay, and then apply. And here we can use standard. You can right click over here. You just click on this, and there is a import temperature dependent. So this is our horizontal case scenario. So that's why we will going to use tangent air, horizontal cylinder. Now you will find based on that the heat transfer coefficient. If you keep in this, it is basically, you will find how it is going to be for 100 degree or for 1000 degree, it is like 12.4 watt per meter square degree centigrade. But it is basically a 5.76, as we have only these two temperature effects below 100 degree. Okay, so like that you just need to apply. Now we can similarly apply for a, we can hide this, and we can further apply insert convection, you can select, as we will going to assume that air will going to come on all these faces, and here also we going to apply the same horizontal second air horizontal cylinder case. Okay, now we can delete the existing two which I created earlier. Okay, so here like three loads. The very first is that our internal temperature, and the second one is that convection on the solid body, and third is convection on the shell bodies. Now we can solve the simulation. Okay, so let it be solved. So you, once you will click over here, you will find the different loads which we have applied. Now we can check the temperature. We just apply, adjust to limit, and if you see here, the temperature is varying from here. It is like approximately 100. You can assume that, because that is what the inside fluidic temperature which will going to come in a picture. But here, as air is coming in contact, so that's why from 100 it will going to reduce the 38 at the bottom faces. Okay. So like that, you will find the different temperature varying like that. Okay. So now we can, once our steady state thermal is done, then you just need to drag static structural over here, and you just need to connect the solution with the setup. Now very first we will perform the static structural simulation, that is called thermal coupled structural analysis. So for that, the very first we need to apply a boundary condition. Now we can select this washer faces and apply. Similarly, the another one we can select these faces. Okay, so I'm not selecting the complete face, I'm just selecting the washer faces. Okay, and the loads in this case is nothing but when you will connect this, you will find the imported loads. So here you just need to separate that six bodies. Basically, you can say the solid bodies, and humerally you can say the shell bodies. Once you will connect this existing results with the setup, you will find this important load tab, and there you can apply the loads. Right click, insert, and body temperature. Okay, now we can right click here and import the loads. So now it is importing the temperature from the thermal analysis. Okay, let's check that. So here it is 100 to 95, and here it is basically 38 to this thing. So if you come click on both, you will find the same as we saw here. Okay, now let's talk about the fixed supports. And in this space, first case, we are assuming that both saddles have the fixed support, so there is no any kind of slot on the sliding, or we can assume that both are the fixed support. So for that present case, for the fixed support case, let's see the what are the stresses and deformation. Let's see. Now our results are performed. Now I will just make the units in millimeter so that you will get more idea. Now if you see here, it is already true scale. If you put like true scale like that, and you will find the maximum over here, because it is trying to expand along the fixed support. We fix that, and due to the thermal effect, it will try to expand. Let's put the some scale, that is 100. 100 is too high, so we'll put 20. Okay, and let's try to animate. So now what is happening, I will put some more scale, that is 50, and let's animate. So what is happening now, if you see over here, due to the 50 degree temperature, due to the 100 degree over here, and we fix that, it is trying to expand, and both supports behaving as a fixed support over here, right? Now so let's see the stresses. So now if you see the stress values is approximately 286 at the bottom, and at this connections also it is approximately 200. Okay. Similarly, I think the same you will find over here, 186 and 190. Okay. So this is the case of fixed support. Now let's see, when we put this sliding support, is there any effect? Is there any effect on stresses? Okay. So why high stresses in this case? And because we are not allowing these two faces to expand, and we are in actual, if you see here also some temperature will going to act, or it will try to expand, but at present we are not allowing to expand. So that's why we are getting this much high stresses. Okay, let's go with the another simulation. Now here the very first we need to apply the fixed support on these two faces. Okay, and then you need to apply right click insert. There is an option called displacement. So what we can do now, we can select these two faces, apply, and here you will find there is a displacement you can apply in X, Y and Z direction. So what we can do now, we can put it 0, so it will not allow to expand in X. We will put in Z as a 0, so it will not allow to expand, but we will do Y as a free. Okay, so that it can allow to expand in this direction. So basically up to this slot provision, from this end to this end, it will going to expand. And the same you need to do the import load for solid as well as shell body. Import load. Okay, so now if you see here, this another deck we just created here, that is fixed support. Okay. And here it is sliding support. Let's open this further. I think the simulation is performed. Imported temperature is imported. Let's solve the simulation. So before that, I will delete the existing which I created earlier. So here the fixed support over this sliding support over that. Let's solve the simulation. So once simulation is done, then we will compare the results. Okay. Now let's talk about the total deformation. Now if you see the deformation, we put some scale, that is 50. We'll have the same deformation at this end, but if you see, we'll just let's animate. Now if you see the animation, you will find the difference. In earlier case, you can see this saddle, it is also allowing to expand in Y direction. Okay, let's see over here. So this is what the case of fixed support, and this is nothing but your sliding support, right? Let's talk about the stresses. This is what your directional deformation. Directional deformation is nothing but your deformation in X, Y and Z direction. At present we are highlighting in this Y direction. So let's see what is the deformation over here. 1.67, approximately 1.69, or you can say the 1.7. okay, so 1.7 the directional deformation. And let's talk about the stresses. Now if you see here, the stresses are 148 megapascal. So here it is max, and here also it is showing. Okay, you need to put properly. Similarly 85, over here it is 41. Similarly at these connections, okay, 73, and here it is approximately 100. Now if you compare with the earlier stresses, you will find it is 286 maximum here, and approximately you can assume that it is in the range of 200, while in a case of sliding support it is in the range of 150, or you can say in the range of 100.
So approximately your 100 megapascal stresses are reduced. So this is basically due to the effect of we are allowing one of the leg to slide in a translation direction. So as we discussed earlier, that when we talk about thermal stresses, when we talk about thermal analysis, and when we talk about thermal coupled structural analysis, in that case boundary condition plays the major role. So the thermal stresses always varies based on your what are the boundary conditions you have provided. So always keep in mind, when we talk about thermal simulation, you should rethink on your boundary conditions. Okay, now as we discuss the two deck, there is one more deck, that is fixed support and displacement. But here I had applied a displacement that is 1.7. So as we saw that directional deformation in the first case is here, it is 1.69, that is 1.7. So let's see the cross or reverse way. We will just going to apply the 1.7. So it will going to allow only 1.7 mm and then it will fix. So how I have calculated this, you can measure that, or even you can calculate the analytically. So now if you see that the thermal displacement is calculated analytically, that by using equation called as alpha, delta T and L. So here alpha for stainless steel is nothing but 1.7 e raised to minus 5, while delta T is nothing but your fluid temperature minus reference temperature, while the displacement, while the length is nothing but the length between the two legs, is 1290 mm. So now you can see the alpha delta T L is nothing but 1.7, and the same what we saw in our thermal simulation here directional. Okay, so it is as same as that. So now you can apply the same delta T over here and let's see the stresses, whether it will going to vary or it will be the same. Okay, so here we fix that, and here we applied that displacement. So like that also, suppose you don't want to define your sliding support, then you can easily calculate analytically the alpha delta TL, and then you can apply that displacement, and you can also see the same deformation. So if you see, the deformation is like same 2.7 kind of thing, and here also it is 2.7. okay, now if you animate that, you will also find the as same as that. Okay, and the stresses are also in the same range, right? 100. Okay, so it means that you can do the two different ways. You can do by two different ways. The first way is that you can actually define the sliding support, and other way is that you can define that by using delta TL analytically. Okay, so now as we discuss here, first we perform fixed support, then we perform sliding support, and then we perform thermal displacement effect. So here if you see the stresses, stress range in the first case is here, it is approximately 200, and in the second case is approximately 100 max I'm talking about, and in the third case is also, if you ignore this, you will find at this, sorry, we will find here it is in the same range approx. Okay, so like in the range of 200 here, I will just put as much as possible, and it is also in the range of same 100 to 140. Okay, so you will find when we talk about fixed support, it is very huge, almost double. When we talk about sliding support, then it is less. So that is what the conclusion of our present video. So you need to think, when we perform such a simulations. So here we know that the effect of boundary condition in case of thermal analysis. So let me know your comments. I'll be there to help you. Thank you. Bye bye. Take care.